Hey everyone, it's Ace coming at you live with another fantastic episode from the Razy Show. How's everybody doing on this fine day in the Philippines? You know what? I love talking to you people because I love fucking talking because I love you people. That's why. You know what? I'm going to have a special guest on today. You know what? This show's entitled today, but it doesn't really have to be the whole show. It's called Can We Patch This Up? What does that mean? What does it mean in a relationship? Your relationship is everything you have that God gave you. If God gives you someone to love, someone to cherish, someone to hold, and someone to care for, What's your end goal? What's your goal in that relationship that makes you want to be with that person? And do you want to be with that person? Do you love that person? Was it love at first sight or love at first bite? You know what? Life is it's like a game now. It's evolved from what it used to be back in the 50s. My father, God rest his soul, and my mother, God rest her soul, grew up in a different time, a different era. They grew up in the Great Depression. My father was actually a trumpet player in the Army, and he became a famous jazz musician later on in life. But you know what? Times are different now. We rely on technology for everything. And you know what? That's just the way it is. Time, evolution. Every day seems to go by faster and faster, you know? And we need to really reconform what we're thinking in life to what's right and wrong. When we have a relationship, we need to cherish that. Hold on, I have an itch in my back. We need to cherish every moment of what we have. And please leave your comments, share, like, and follow my page. Please. You know, my only support is your like, share, and follow. Nobody has sent me any stars so far. If my content is boring, tell me. I don't think it is. So, the title of today's is Can We Patch It Up? Meaning there's a rough time in a relationship. Can you resolve it? Can you fix it? Do you want to fix it? Husband and wife. Is the wife hating the husband? Is the husband hating the wife? Do you guys have children? And you're showing no love in the family? Love is the most important thing in the world. It makes us human beings. I mean human beings. Evil makes us evil. But love makes us better people every day. And we really need to analyze every day before you get mad, before you argue, before something irritates. Look, we all meet that special person that catches our eye, you know, that attraction is animal attraction, it's called, and the attraction is great, but what is the outcome? Because you meet that person, you're having a great time, you fall in love, you're kissing, or whatever else you're doing, get married, but then maybe that person doesn't want to move in with you until she's married. But men are different. Men will sleep with a woman before they're married, And it's okay. That's your choice between you and your partner. And you need to think what's going to happen when we move in, right? You don't know that person that well until you really move in together and start living together. You don't know their bad habits. You don't know if they're cooking or cleaning. You don't even know if they're going to take care of your kids if you have any. But only time will tell the true colors of a person. You know that? That's the truth. The true colors of a human being come out through time. Over time, you learn who each other are. And you learn if you can really be compatible. That's the truth. But if you do get married, you need to really focus on forgiving, giving, and sharing your life. Life about sharing. I'm trying to bring a friend on as a special guest right now. And I think the connection is slow. Hold on. You know what? Hold on. So it's about sharing, caring, loving. It's about integrity, honesty, not lying, stealing, and cheating. That doesn't have a place in your life if you fall in love. It really doesn't. It's useless. So I just invited my friend, but I don't think he knows he's supposed to accept the invite. This is crazy. Dan, accept the invite when I send it to you if you want to go live with me. Accept the invite. Yeah. So here I am at Tivoli. I came for a three cheese pizza, but they don't have cheese for the pizza. And then I asked for a cheeseburger, a hamburger. And they don't have buns for the burgers. Oh my gosh, what's happening? You declined my invite. Oh my gosh, what happened? Why did you decline my invite? So, you know, and the other questions are, let's see if he declines it now again. Oh, here he is. He's coming on board. On board the Ace. He's coming on board the Ace boat.
Hello. Hello, hello, everyone.
Hey, you look great.
Thank you.
As always. As always.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
You're Canadian guapo.
Yes.
You're Canadian indeed. Guapo.
Indeed.
So we're talking about, right now this isn't going to be a long segment. It's kind of getting boring, but you know what? Relationships and how you have to share, care, love, and accept your flaws. Is that something that you can do in your life? Care, share, and accept their flaws?
Well, it's important. This is something that the two of you or the two of them have to do in order for the relationship to survive. Because relationships are like the wave of the sea. It's up and down. When the sea is calm, relationship is so easy, it just flows. But when there's tidal waves and there's problems, it's very difficult. So the two of them, two individuals, need to be forgiving to each other and embrace each other's. That's simple.
Excuse me? Yeah. You know what? I think, hold on, let me just try to get this to turn. Is the music too loud?
I cannot hear any music.
Good.
You probably have a device called sounds suppressor. Like, it's,
I don't know,
device.
My phone's really good, yeah. That's all I know. So
yeah, there's no background.
In my life, I'm 59. I don't know how old you are. How old are you?
Oh, I'm like 39.
Oh, you look really good. So, in my life, forgiveness, when I was young and dumb, I think forgiveness wasn't really the main focus. I think it was when I was younger. If I look back at my younger years in the 20s, right, I was just, I met my first wife. We were together 29 years. She was from Poland. I mean, her relatives were from Poland. She was blonde. The whitest skin you ever saw in your life. The most beautiful girl you ever saw, and like a model. But
I think you're wrong. I think your current wife is the most beautiful.
Maybe. But her heart isn't as, I don't know. Hey, let's just get, so she's beautiful, but she needs to focus on her. She's young, so she doesn't really know how to, I don't know how the image, the mind is not as, the heart, I don't know if it's the heart or the mind, not as, I don't, it's not forgiving, it's just trying, you know, when you look at somebody and you're dealing with somebody every day, again, it goes back to accepting each other's flaws, whether it's leaving a dish of food on the counter, and when I look at that, when I get up at 2 a.m. and I have to jingle, and I see food out, and I see cockroaches walking around, it irritates me, but it's not going to push me to the point where I'm going to confront her and get, there's no like anger involved. You know, there's no real, because I understand, over the years I started to understand what people really are and how they act, and what you can't, somebody told me once, you can't change anyone else as much as you want to. You can only change yourself.
Well, this is the reason, this is one, and this is a perfect example of you picking up the flaws of your partner to make your relationship complete. For example, if there's food at night, you know she's not gonna pick it up and remember, she's a mother, she's responsible for like 3 kids. Then you're the one to pick it up and put the food away and be an example to her, so that in the morning she comes and she'll look and she'll be amazed. And you need to be consistent about it. And really, what is it to pick up food? It's only a couple minutes. And as husband, we can't say, oh, it's a wife's job to do the dishes, it's a wife's job to do the laundry. We're in 2024 where partner needs to help each other, and especially if you want the relationship to be successful, you see one partner as a flaw, and then what you do, you encourage them, you remind them that, hey, you know, you explain to them, and sometimes it takes time, but By being the example, you are really picking up the flaw of a partner that you love. And I think this is the beauty of love. You know, like, I'm the same as you. I really absolutely hate foods. I mean, maybe from where I grew up, I don't know, and my background, and as, you know, working along with police officers, that we were trained to be very, very organized and clean, because, you know, without it, you can't see clarity. You don't have clear clarity of mind. So your car needs to be spotless and inside out and so on and so forth. So it makes life easier. And the same, I think, in when you see a partner, I had past partner actually that aggravated me that way, that I discontinued the relationship. Listen, most beautiful people, like you said, but for me, it did not work, and I'm glad I walked away, because now I found a person that very similar, and neither of us are perfect, but we're perfect together. So it's that's simple as that, right?
That's beautiful, nicely said, and nicely put, and to the point. I think of, like I said, I'm going to go back to now. Yeah, like you said, we're in 2024 now. It's people just want, the younger crowd especially, they want instant gratification, and it doesn't really work like that. That's not how the universe works. That's not how God works. He doesn't give you instant gratification just because you want it now. You know, he doesn't give you what you want now because you want it and you are you. That's ego.
Yeah,
being ego is a big part in being.
It's really
being desensitized by electronics, by TV, by drama, fake actresses who play parts of people. They just the funny thing is, I'm watching, because we live in a condo now, where, you know, in a more expensive condo than we were living before, but the TV is just so super fake, dramatic. It just blows my mind. I mean, you got a drama where I don't even know, because I don't understand the language. It's not in English, but what I'm observing is they jump out of a car with AK-47s with semi-automatics and they're going to kill this guy. You know, that kind of stuff isn't reality, you know? You're not going to go in the streets of Manila, go eat some chicken and have a truckload of guys jump out with semi-automatics and want to kill you, because that's just TV drama. It's Hollywood plus. And what I found really amazing here is that if you watch it, what you watch and what you listen to becomes you. It really does. What you fill your mind with, what you absorb every day becomes you. And it's sad because, so as an example, I've been in my relationship for 5 years. And no, I'm not going to talk about this on camera. I'll talk about it in personal. Anyways, desensitization has become a disease of the brain, and it affects the heart. That's what you're listening to, right? Right. It's like, let's just say you adopt a dog. I'm trying to compare apples to apples, but this is something that came to my mind. You adopt the dog, and you tell the dog, I love you, you know, I'm going to take care of you, don't worry, the dog was abused before, but then you stop feeding that dog for days, and then the dog starts to get depressed. I mean, eventually, it's going to become desensitized to you. It's going to break away. It's going to hate you naturally, because if you're not feeding your loved one, if you don't do that, there's a sense of hatred and depression. They go together. But you know what? Watching the things on the YouTube, watching the things on TikTok. I mean, I'm guilty for joining TikTok because I needed another platform, which I always hated the fact of that I never wanted to join TikTok, but I don't like what the young girls do on TikTok, their dances and stuff. I don't like it. I never did. I don't like the way they unbutton their pants, show their tongue. You know, there's too many perverts out there that just don't care about, they don't care about those women. They're just watching what they want to watch. You agree?
The thing with this, what I can offer as advice, but not even as advice, but more like as a comment, is even myself. Sometimes whenever you post on Facebook or on TikTok, you have to realize that that will follow you for the rest of your life. So when you're a grandmother, people will look back at this and see your display or your behavior. And some of the young people at the time, they said, well, I don't care. But deep down, they will care, because this is something that follows you. So if ever, for example, you have a chance, life can turn around for a person. For example, that person could become a famous person, and then this will be used against them, against their personality, against everything about them. And they'll point out to them, look at their behavior. And the thing is, that's why you have to be careful. There's nothing wrong in TikTok to dance and to have fun if you're dressed appropriately, and not you know, all these sexual moves. So that's what people have to understand. Are you prepared to leave this as a token of your personality forever? You'll bring that with you in the grave. So that's where you have to remember about this.
Right.
We live in a world of people wants to have everything quick, like you explained about self-gratification right away. The issue, it stems, like the issue about this stems for a long, long time ago. Even if you read the Bible, if you're like, you know, if you're into that. But if you just look at history without reading the Bible, if you look at history, the Roman Empire became so, so very powerful, including the Catholic Church, which is part of the Roman Empire, really, because it's called Roman Catholic Church. What happened is they have to find a way to control the crowd. I mean, yeah. You have a crowd of millions of people. They have to have a way. If not, they will lose the crowd. So the Romans' way, what it was, is they would entertain people. So it was by entertaining. They did not have TV back there. There was no TikTok, no Facebook. But what they had fights into the Roman places. They would have like clowns all over the place animating the people, just to let the people forget who's running the show. And the people were forced to be compelled because nothing was serious. Oh, it's not serious. It's just gladiator, lion eating the gladiators and vice versa. But today what they did, today you have social media controlling the crowd. And what people do not know is that the social media is controlled by the government. The large medias are 100% controlled by the government. In my country, in Canada, we have the CBC, Canada Broadcasting Corporation, which is a crown corporation, meaning a government funded with the tax dollar of the taxpayer. It's funded by that. So these all become mouthpiece of those who govern to control the crowd. So if the young people, not just young people, adult also, could understand that, hey, when you are on social media, just be careful. Always stay polite, because this is a legacy of who you are, what you did. And the only thing we can leave after we leave this earth is our reputation, really. That's all you can leave. So it's better to have a good reputation and then, you know, be branded as somebody that is in Bisaya or in Filipino, I could say Boricat, look like a Boricat. That means a person of low moral standard. So basically it's that, right? But right now the subject, what we went away from what the subject was, which was about with our partner, how we can improve our relationship and make our relationship stand, and also fall in love again with our partner. And the only way that could be achieved is, I believe, is to accept each other's flaw, and also to work to in order to for the flaw to kind of disappear, even if it's there, is one have to step up. You always have to be the bigger one, and then always remind your partner that you don't need to remind them you love them, but you have to remind them how precious they are to you, and how precious you appreciate to be with them. Because yeah, could you imagine?
Of course.
Could you imagine not be with your partner? Like, say the partner decided, okay, I had enough, I'm getting out. I'm sure you've been through that. It's hell. It's hell to have your partner leave you. But that's always a possibility when the threshold of one, you know, like one feels disrespected, one feels that you don't understand them. So that's where, like, it's work. Relationship is work, but it's beautiful work, because at the end of the day, if you have found the person that you care for, you will want to work. You'll be like, no, let me do this. I'd like to, you know, just relax, you know, and it's vice versa.
Right. Agreed. So what I'll end this subject, this one here, on, you know what, people, put the cell phones down, put the computers down for 10 minutes when you get home from work, and just love your husband, wife, partner, live-in, whatever you want to call them. They call them many things in the Philippines, more than they do in the U.S., but whoever they are, you know.
Yeah. Your wife and besides, yeah.
Tell your kid.
Tell your wife kids, is your asawa.
Tell your kids, you know, I tell my kid all the time, I tell my son, Gabriel wants to story me, wants to do this and do that, and I'm stressed about something, and I say, Gabriel, you know what? At the end of the day, I love you so much, and I'm not mad at you. I'm just an old grumpy man that's stressed, and you need to understand that, because that's the truth and the reality. Patience wears as we get older. It doesn't become stronger. It becomes less. Unfortunately, that's the fact of life. And that's genetics. Also, patience is built in our genetic code. How patient was your father? How patient was your mother? Just look at the past. But you know what? We can learn from being patient and trying to just... I practice every day. I practice being submissive in the sense of don't get up, don't blow up, don't get mad, don't freak out, don't get really mad at him. Just tell him stop if you want him to stop doing something, you know. As an example, Gabriel, stop. I know you're bored. I know it's a small condo and we need to get out and you're bored. And he's wild. He's got Philippines, half Philippine, and he's half American. That mix is not just good, but it's powerful. They have, when you make a half baby like that, they are wild. I never knew how wild they would be, but you know what? So I put my arms around him and I say, I'm sorry if I was grumpy. I do that all the time because the last thing I want is my son to feel like that I don't love him. So I'm going to end this subject at that. Get off your computers. Get off your phones. The rent will be paid. Your bills will be paid. You have to pray and just keep your faith, because your family's everything. If you don't have your family, if you don't have your health, you got nothing. We're not guaranteed tomorrow. We're not even guaranteed the next minute. I might die doing this podcast. We're not guaranteed nothing. It's like we get nothing for free, even though we think it's free. And I mean, God could allow a massive earthquake in the Philippines right now that's just going to shake your house down to the ground, and you're going to be killed by rubble. It hasn't happened yet. You know why? Because God has graced you, even though you don't realize it, even though you don't go to church, and even though you don't pray. And that's the truth. I'm going to end it now on this subject. I'm Ace from The Razy Show, and I love you people. And I love
you. Okay, thank you. Thank you.
And now I'm going to talk about, I just wanted to ask Dan, because he found a new love, and I'm excited for him. It's hard to find new love, a new life, a new path. A new way.
Yeah, well, when,
right. Can I ask you something? Wait. Can I ask you something?
Yes.
How did you guys meet?
I'm sorry?
How did you guys meet each other?
Oh. We actually, I went out to celebrate the birthday of somebody, a friend of mine, a good friend of mine, and enjoyed the birthday. And at the time, I was single, and somebody of her family, I guess, told her that, hey, Dan is a single guy and he seemed to be a nice guy. And so she put me to the test. She put me to the test to see, is it true that, you know, this guy's nice? So anyway, so we build up a relationship this way, met her family, became friend with the family, became accepted with the family. So, yeah. So that's how we met. Yeah, basically we did not meet.
So was it love at first sight or love at first bite? Yo. Yo. Hello? Uh-oh, what happened to the video? Thank you.